Hello, I'm Gauri Joshi from Dr. Kalmadi Shamrao High School, Ganesh Nagar, Pune. I have been associated with the school for 4 years. We are following CS Pathshala curriculum over past 6 years. Scratch programming allows children to visualize their coding, helps in logical thinking, making the entire process more enjoyable. So let us see how we implemented CT features in a simple example of ball and paddle game in Scratch, which is taken for standard 7. We started the project by dividing the complex program into simple, smaller, manageable units. Example, we divided this process into two sections, designing and coding. Designing was adding of all the sprites, to paint the sprites if needed, etc. And the coding process involved further divisions into different small tasks, such as we concentrated on how the ball is moved in the random position, then how a paddle is moved, and then we focused on how ball is hitting the brick. Also, we introduced a variable score. So in this way, dividing the entire problem into smaller parts made the job easy. Students were able to write script independently on their own. So after recomposition was achieved, we focused on which part of the game was important. So ball hitting the paddle, when paddle was stationary and paddle was moving, this part of the game was important. So abstraction was achieved. Then we decided that if we want to add the difficulty level into the game, what can be considered? We can consider the direction of the ball, the speed in which the ball is moving. If we want to add many balls to this particular game, this was the pattern observed. The script was written for one single ball and it can be repeated or reused for multiple balls, keeping into consideration the direction of the ball, the speed of the ball, etc. In this way, we achieved pattern recognition. And after applying all these steps, after coming to the conclusion, the children or the students wrote this particular steps into a proper sequential format. So in this way, algorithmic thinking or algorithm was achieved. In this game, you can see, first we concentrated on the movement of the ball in any random position where ball is hitting the paddle. This was the first division, or this was the first section of the project. Then we focused on movement of paddle as well as movement of the ball. This was the second section of our project, where both the sprites were moving. Then we focused on achieving or increasing the difficulty level where multiple balls are introduced and changing the direction and the speed. Pattern recognition was achieved. And the last step or last division of the work was, last section of the work was ball hitting the bricks, and the variable is also increasing. In this way, we divided the entire process into 4 to 5 different parts. In this way, the objective of designing and developing the game was achieved using CT features. With the spread of novel coronavirus, many problems arose. In a flash of second, everything turned online. Time was enclosed in four walls of a house. But this situation made us aware about many technological advances. Schools were functional online, and also the classes were conducted online using different modes of video conferencing, and students were in the online class. Even the exams were conducted online. This was the first time where this online platform was used. This pandemic situation, students had to give exams online, and many students experienced network issues or connectivity issues, due to which they were terminated from the exam portal, or they were eliminated, or they were removed from the exam portal. This problem was faced by many students, and this problem was noticed by a group of students named Samruddha, Vihanga, etc., who came up with an idea to solve this problem by implementing the exam portal software called as Comet, completely offline mass examination system. This entire project also was following CT features. So in this way, the pattern abstraction was achieved where exam termination was removed, focusing only on the important feature that students will not be getting out of the exam. So this particular software also was divided into different sections or into different smaller manageable units. For example, generation of question paper from the examiner's side, saving of answers from the student side, uploading and submitting the answers from the student side, and examiners receiving the answers of the students. This particular division or breaking the complex problem into smaller units help the students to think entirely and individually on that particular section of the program. So after this particular decomposition was achieved, students thought about how can we achieve this for multiple subjects with different types of questions. So a pattern was repeated. They noticed this particular for one subject and tried to implement the same code for different subjects in which a pattern was achieved or pattern recognition feature of CT was achieved. After writing all these particular steps in a proper order, they came up with an algorithm and designed this particular project in Python programming language. Let me show you some of the GUIs developed in Python. So these are some GUIs students were able to develop in Python programming, which shows account login, paper name, paper duration, types of questions to be uploaded, etc. This particular project was mentored by Mrs. Manisha Girulkar Madam, and developing an application or GUI in a language like Python requires one to be good in programming concepts. So interested students who have an urge to go beyond the basics and have similar interest come together and work as a team. The CT features help the students to be in the top 50 teams in ATL Marathon. ATL in our school has provided a platform for young innovators to work on their ideas and to try and solve real life problems which are faced by their friends, families, etc. One such example we came across in this pandemic was touchless thermal doorbell project taken by Aryan and Ananya. When a person used to visit the house from outside, chances of him being infected and ringing the doorbell with the same hands was problem. So that particular person's temperature should be recorded and sanitizer also should get spread. And if he is carrying any parcel, that parcel was also to be accepted. All these things have to be done without any contact with that person, that is contactless. This was the problem faced by us in this pandemic situation. This problem was understood by Aryan and Ananya, and they came up with an idea of touchless thermal doorbell. This particular device was fitted on the door to check the temperature and spray sanitizer to the visitor entering the house without actually touching the device. So even this project followed CT features. Let us see one by one. The particular project was divided into different smaller sections, such as touching of device was avoided. Then they focused on recording the temperature, spraying the sanitizer, then ringing the bell with the help of hand gestures, etc. These three sections, the project was divided. Now, our focus was on how to ring the doorbell without coming into the direct contact of the doorbell. So, children thought about using of gestures. So, the bell was ringing with the help of hand gestures. This was the main important highlight of the project, where we can say abstraction was achieved. After working on these two things, students noticed that spraying of sanitizer and checking the temperature, both of these things required touchless concept, that is no contact concept. So a pattern was achieved. They noticed the pattern that the device has not to be touched in both of these cases, sanitizer getting spread and checking of the temperature. So they thought of some sensor that would fit into this particular situation. So writing of all these particular things into proper way helped them to come up with algorithm. In this project, students use different sensors and learned about their applications and used this the example of the device which Aryan and Ananya thought about. We encouraged them to use various platforms provided by CS Pathshala as well as participate in different coding projects and competitions like Cyber Genius, Smart School Hackathons, etc., which are conducted by our school. These competitions help them to compete in Scratch programming, app development, Python programming, etc., which develops not only logical thinking and reasoning skills, but also creativity, collaboration, and communication skills. Our school recognizes the importance of developing these skills in the young students. Hence, the school has incorporated co-scholastic subjects like computer, PE, art, yoga, ATL into our online timetable. Implementing the CT approach in our project and coding made our job easy, and we were able to implement the mentioned facilities in our project, said some. Computational thinking embraces the methods and abilities to express and solve problems in the language that a computer could understand, process, and execute. Computational thinking can be broken down into different facets of thought, each with its own particular strength and applications. Thank you.